My name is Torsten Norgaard. I'm a Danish photographer. I travel the world taking photographs and teaching photography. Today I will talk about the Leica SL2, the five things you have to know about this camera. I also have a special Leica SL2 bundle that if you go to the link below here, there's a special offer where you can save more than $1,000 on this camera. The first thing to know about the Leica SL2 is that it's the new model from the Leica SL that came out in 2015. And there's not much difference to see on the surface, which is good. It means that the first Leica SL was actually pretty well built, well designed, and well thought through. Actually, it was so well thought through by Leica to do a new SL camera, or basically SLR without the reflex, without the mirror inside, that Canon, Nikon, and other camera producers have followed with also new cameras very similar to this one. But Leica is the first one that came with it, and this is the second edition of it. The reason I got this one is not that I really need an upgrade of it, because the first Leica SL actually works really well. But some of the things that are really good about this is that it have rounded corners now. It has here a rubber grip that is actually covering for mini jack and HDMI. And it has inside here the hand grip. It has like a soft rubber, so you hold on to it. So it just gives a very good grip on this camera. And the whole camera, even if it's actually 50 to 100 grams more heavy than the Leica SL, it feels more lightweight. Especially if you put on a 90 2.0 like an L lens, you get a really what feels like a compact package for a camera that can do this much. So for no other reason, this would be a reason to upgrade to the SL2, that is just a more slick camera. The second thing that you should know about the Leica SL2 is that it has become simplified. Well, it both simplified and improved. So the first SL was really good. This one has been refined. It's a little bit like a Leica Q that Leica did. The first camera was a big sales success, a really nice camera, and then they did the Q2, and nothing really happened. You can hardly tell on the outside of the camera that it's a new camera, but it's a bigger sensor. You could say that's the feature excuse for upgrading the camera. But all the small design things and improvements you could make on the Q, they did. So that's the same with the SL. And one of the improvements that you will notice is that now on the back of the camera here, there's just three buttons. And when you go into the menu, you just have a very simple menu here for both video and one for still photography. And it's a touch screen, so you can simply just touch. And you can also scroll over here, ISO 200, and I can just roll up 3200, click, and now change the ISO. So there's a lot of great improvements, and they're very subtle. There's also the two buttons here in the front that you can use to focus in, and you can actually program them to whatever you want. So the simplicity of Leica, that's what Leica is about, besides the quality. And this one have even more simplicity, and it's very logical to use. The third thing you should know about the Leica SL is that one of the breakthroughs that Leica did when they did the SL is that they said, okay, we're going to reinvent a Leica SLR, or the SLR camera that was kind of dying out almost. We're going to reinvent it, we're going to remove the mirror, and we're going to make it a very slick package, a very modern camera, and that's what they did. But also part of making this camera is that you put in a great sensor and you put a big enough opening so you can now fit a lot of different lenses. And I'll just dig out some of the features you have of this camera, that now you can put on all the interesting lenses. Here I have some, this is actually 7 artisan lens for like an M that fits on this, and you can see on this one I have the Noctlux lens, which is one of the reasons to get the SL, that now you have the viewfinder, you can see the Noctlux really clear. More M lenses. You can also add some of the classic R lenses. This is the zoom R lens. It's a really good lens. They sell for very cheap on eBay, and via adapter they fit on the SL. So all these lenses, now you can add them to the SL, and you can even go back to Leica lenses, Leica M lenses, screw mount lenses back from 1925 and onward. And of course, there's also the lenses made for the Leica SL, the L Alliance, so that's Sigma, Panasonic and Leica, that joined together said we're going to develop and make new lenses for this camera series that Panasonic, Sigma and Leica is making, and others joined in. So you have seven artisans and others that also joined in with L-mount lenses. So when you get this camera now, even if it's only been 5 years in the market, there's so many lenses to choose from in all price ranges, from, you could say, cheap Sigma to more expensive Panasonic, and then to, you could say, the luxury, the optimum lenses, the Leica L lenses. Number four in like the SL2 is the EVF here. This is the electronic viewfinder. And in old SLR cameras, you would look through this one and mirrors and you would look through the lens. Now you look through this one, you see a screen in here and it sees what the lens sees or what the sensor sees. And that makes it very precise to use the camera. You can say that's not new. That's what all so-called mirrorless cameras have, is that they don't have a mirror, but they have a screen where you look. What is unique about this one, you can say it sticks out a little bit here because you can change here for your eyesight. But this one have not only a very high resolution screen and very accurate in colors inside, it also have the optics here so you can actually see the screen really well without any tweaked out corners or anything. So it's very clear and precise. And suddenly you can take a very demanding lens like the 50mm Noctilux 0.95 from the M series, and you can put it on this one and you can actually focus it without having to zoom in. You can also zoom in, but you don't have to. And this EVF, the simplicity of the camera and how professional it is, actually makes this camera also a really good companion for people who wants to take professional photographs but doesn't necessarily know a lot about photography. This camera is very easy, even with a manual lens. You give it to somebody and you say, just look for the viewfinder, and you turn the focus here and you take a photo when it's sharp. And that's something people can find out to do and they can get really good results. Then you could say if you add the L lenses, then you get autofocus. And you could say that's also great, that makes it even easier, but manual focus is actually easy for people. You could say autofocus is almost for people who is out of training. But that is part of it. You can do the autofocus lenses, you can do manual focus lenses, and anybody you just give the camera to, they can actually figure out how to make a photograph with this camera. That's how simple it is and how great the EVF is. It just makes sense. This is what you see. It's almost like looking on an iPhone screen and you click when press take the photo. When you see it looks right. So that's how simple it is. The fifth and the last thing I will point out on this camera is that now we have 50 megapixel sensor, and we have higher ISO, we have better image stabilization, we have all the features that when boys sit and compare cars or cameras or whatever, they have an excuse for why is this a better camera than the SL, and it is a better camera on all accounts. For me it doesn't really matter, I didn't need higher ISO, I didn't need more megapixel. But it just comes with the camera, and you can say that's great. It's the same price as the SL2 when that came out, so you just get more for the money and you get more perfection. That's the five things on this camera. I'll also mention this strap I have on here. This is the rock and roll strap. This is the one called Red Dot, so it's actually limited because I have the red here. You can get it completely black, and you can go to the website. I put a link below here to rock and roll and get it. It's a really good strap for this special fitting on the SL2. The camera of course comes with a strap, but this is just a very nice strap. It's very elastic and nice to use. That's all I had to say. Also, see the offer below. You can get an SL2 with extra battery and a workshop package. So you save around $1,000 on the camera, and that's only as long as they're in stock for that package. That's all I had to say. Till I see you next time, remember, always wear a camera.